Hey, Tubal Views, welcome back. Today is a little teeny thing, nothing major. I just wanted to show you something.
Remember
check
this
it out.
Yeah, it's the green, shiny cobalt, shiny oxidized cobalt. We put the cobalt emblems on. It turns out that we forgot, maybe I forgot, to order the hole numbers. So I don't know if you can see this, but they're in there. I mean, it's an older boat, and these numbers have been on here for a while. So what I'm going to do is take some heavy cut and some perfected EXAC with a wool pad. And there's the wool pad. There's the heavy cut, and here's the perfected EXAC. And all I'm going to do is grind on this a little bit until I can get the color to match. Once I get the color to match, I'll strip this and I'll reapply the hull numbers. I think you'll like them because they match the back a lot. So give me a sec. So I'm just going to use the 3M heavy cut. Can you see that? Just the heavy cut.
As long as you don't ignore it, if it's going to go away, it probably won't.
Yeah.
Try
Okay.
I'm gonna move your
part. No, you're not. You're gonna plug me back in, please.
Yeah.
You don't need to move my car.
It's already plugged in. What are you talking about?
Oh. Quick side note, for all those monkeys out there that don't think that compounding can remove oxidation, what exactly do you think that green color is in the wheel? Huh? Well, we've got some color match. There is some topographical elevation change. However, since we're putting new decals right over these, it shouldn't be very much of a problem.
Okay.
So let me add a little perfected EXAC on this. Shouldn't take all that much. And here we go. Same basic stuff. Thank you. Okay. Now, let me go get the stripper. I'll be right back. Okay, I've got the stripper. This is cinnamon. No, actually, it's not. It's Mother's CMX. Cinnamon doesn't show up till 7. She's got a day job. Next step is to call the guy with the responsibility chip and let him put some decals on. So I've got a little bit of a bubble here and one right there, and there's a little bubble here. So a couple things about that. One, you can either let the sun and the heat kind of get rid of that on its own. Two, you can take a pin, like a little sewing pin, and just poke a hole in them. Or a razor blade if you want to. You know what? I should just do that. So, a little razor blade. Them out with a soft rag. If it's a small enough bubble, it'll actually leave generally on its own. I mean, Gelcoat's porous, right? So it will get absorbed into the Gelcoat. Now, I'll just take a little bit of wax, wax it up. A little bit of wax, soft foam pad. Sound healthy. Oh, she's falling apart. Okay, time to buy a new one of these. I guess I dropped it one too many times. Interesting. I've had this buffer for about 11 years. And last weekend I dropped it pretty hard. So I feel bad, it's my fault. I was irresponsible with my own tools. Ta-da! Anyway, so to get the gist, the overall look. You got these nice stainless hole numbers to match the nice cobalt letters. And the boat just kind of comes together. It's a nice touch, I think. I like it. And you can buff over these letters for a long time to come without worrying about them coming off. Cool. All right, thanks for watching. Have a good day. I suppose you already know I'm going to ask for a thumbs up, maybe a comment. Go ahead and subscribe. I'll have more stuff. It's going to be just as boring.